Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to delete data by ID in MongoDB database with the help of Spring Boot. So let's get started. So if you want to watch the entire tutorial how to set up your Spring Boot and MongoDB collection and also to post data, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top, because in this video I'm going to show only the delete operation. So that's good. So now let me just begin by explaining the folder structure. So I'm having like three folders over here. One is controller, model and repository. So these are the three important folders that we need to create so that the code is more readable. So first thing is the model, which contains our class. So in my case, I'm having the student class. So name is student. I'm having three data members, which is roll number, name and address. And these are the data members that we will be sending from our postman. So in case for posting data, we will be sending like this. And next thing is we will be having the repository. So in Spring Boot, each class will be linked to a particular repository. And here we are having the class name over here. And with the help of the object of this repository, we will be able to perform save delete operations. So for example, if I go to my controller, this is where we will be defining the path. Okay, add student, get student, fetch student. So for example, here I'm having this path, add student, here I'm having fetch students. So this is the place where we're defining the URI over here. And as I told you earlier, with the help of the object of this repository, we will be able to save and fetch and delete, perform basically all the operations. So you need to have this over here. So I have explained everything in that video. If you want to watch that, you can just go there and watch it. So now let's begin with the delete function, okay? So first thing, let me just copy the post. Or else you can just type it from start. It's not a big deal at all. Just paste it. So the first important thing is it's not going to be a post mapping. It's going to be delete mapping and just have a custom path. So I will just go with as delete student. And also I will just change the function name of my delete controller. And this is going to be of type void, because I'm not going to return anything. We are not going to return anything as a response. We're just going to delete it. That's it. In case if you want to return something, you can do it. That's totally up to you. And we are going to delete with the help of ID. And for that, we will be passing ID from our URL itself. So for example, it's going to be something like this. For example, we'll be having the delete student over here. After that, we'll put a slash and we will pass the number or ID to be deleted. So basically, we will be having ID over here. So if I pass 1, this entire object will be getting deleted from my database. So for passing it, we will be having here a slash, curly bracket, within that we need to put ID. And we will be accessing this ID with the help of path variable annotation. So it's going to be at path variable space, the data type of this ID. So in my case, I'm having the student, the data type is integer. So put integer and this name, this variable name that we have used over here, that should come over here. And next thing is we need to use this student repo, which is the object that we have created with our student repo interface name. Okay, so we need to have that. Also, you need to like use this way. You need to have the auto void annotation. So it's going to be that object dot we'll be having delete by ID. And inside this ID, we'll be passing the ID that we are passing from our postman in the URL. And now is the most important thing. Okay, you need to go to your class. And in the class, you need to have this ID annotation. So this is super important. This ID annotation basically makes or denotes Spring Boot that this roll number is a primary key. So for example, I'm just going to my postman and I'm sending some data. I'll just go with 5 and I'm just sending 5 over here. Roll number is 5. So if I just send it, yeah, 200. And if I go to my MongoDB compass and if I refresh it, here you can see I'm getting this as ID. But I'm sending it as roll number. So this is the reason why you need to have this ID annotation over here. And because in main controller, we are using delete by ID. So in case if you just pass roll number over here, you will be having the roll number key over here and ID key won't be there. So this function won't be working. So basically you need to have this ID annotation. It's super important. So now we are good. This is basically the delete function. So let me just now rerun my Spring Boot application. I will just copy this path. I think the path is already copied. My Spring Boot application is running on 8081 and I have configured over here. Under resources, we will be having the application.properties. This is my configuration. I'm having the port number and this is my database name, NewDB. So here I'm having my database name and the class name is going to be the default collection name, student. So here I am. Now let me go to Postman. First thing is you need to change the operation to delete. By default, it will be in get, change it to delete. And it's going to be HTTP, not HTTPS, :// localhost and your port number. Since I am using 8081 in my Spring Boot application, I am using this. You need to use your own port number. And after that, this delete student path, which we have specified over here. Exactly the same thing. Be careful with the alphabet cases. Next is going to be slash, and here we need to pass the ID, and I am passing the ID over here as 4. So this is basically the setup, and body we are not going to pass any request body or data, something like that. So let me just clear this and go to compass. If I refresh this, I'm not having 4, so I'll just go with 2 basically. So I'll just go here, I'll put 2, and if I send it, yeah, I'm getting status 200, which means that I'm not facing any errors. So if I go here, yeah, no errors here also. And if I go to my compass, and if I refresh it now, this particular object shouldn't be there. So here you can see 2 is not there. So this is basically how you delete by using a particular ID in MongoDB with the help of Spring Boot. Again, I repeat, super important thing, make sure that you have the ID annotation. So that's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in programming as well as AI, many more CRUD operations by using MySQL, MongoDB, Spring Boot and Node.js, as well as AI related programming videos using OpenAI also. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.